Hello, welcome to the game. So I'll show you how to get your first power armor. It's basically you finding some secrets and selling them, items you find from them. So you just have to wander around the city and find all the items you need and then sell them. And then you have to do something else. Go to the factory and buy the armor from the vending machine. But there are so many things you can miss. For example, this dead body over here. Another weapon mode. And I'll show you another cool weapon mode or armor mode for the armor. Magnum. 50% magazine size, which is so important. Yeah, she couldn't afford medical care, so the company had to, you know, basically let her die. This is a terrible place. So it will be basically me looting the entire city, almost. And then going to the cannery, and then buying the armor, and then doing some other stuff. So, let's get started. It will take you about 10 minutes if you don't have any money, but... depending on your difficulty, you might want to, you know, invest a little extra time in searching all the locations. See, this is just a roundabout. And there are two armors you can buy, so even if you don't have all the money to buy the pristine one, which is the one with the diamond, you can still buy the same thing, only it will, you know, break down faster. This is a good container over here. There should be something else. No, okay. So as you can see, every alleyway will lead you to something to, you know, loot. And it's not stealing because it's looting. Armor parts. If it says take it, it's good. If it says steal, well, make sure no one is watching you. That says short grip. So it will basically decrease the loss of durability. This is actually a pretty good one. Mr. Power, sure grip. Yeah. So you can get a lot of cool weapon mods and armor mods. So by the time you're finished with this area, you'll be almost unstoppable. So let's jump over the barrels. Go here. And this is the safe impact hammer. It's just a hammer that makes a cool sound. Let me show it. I imagine it's a lightsaber. Voom. Voom. It's a very... maybe it's a lightsaber with a sore throat. Yeah, that's the best way to describe it. Come on, change it. Okay, let's get out of here. And over here there is another little thingy. I still don't know what those icons mean, so if you know, let me know. Pick up that magpick, because magpick seems to be, they seem to be so rare that they are so important. They're just extra loot items, but when you actually unlock something good, it will be worth it.
I'm sorry, I'll just be a minute.
You had a minute. Next one comes out of your pay.
Oh, they are so brutal over here. So, in this dark alleyway, I think you had something... can't really remember, but it's something over there. Come on, game, don't mess around with me. It was something down one of those things. Anyway, let's go to the other looting location. Another very good looting location is... is somewhere around here, so let's see. Yeah, a lot of ammunition is available here. Nice, those two crates are very giving to us. Okay, so we basically looted a few locations and we're, well, already very good off. Now let's go to the house of the sick people, or the dying people, or the dead people. This is both tragical and comical at the same time. So as you can see, you have your normal corporate guard. This is just one of the places we looted. Oh, I forgot that one. By the way, it said steal, so remember. Watch your left, watch your right, and then steal it. You can talk to that person, but what I recommend you do is open the doors, let the rats outside, because the guard will kill the rats. Go in here and loot everything. As you can see, it says steal. So if they catch you once, they'll just give you a warning and maybe you can bribe them or, you know, convince them to leave you alone. But the second time, I think they'll just straight up attack you, the whole town. As you can see, that's so scary because she starts shooting, and initially I thought she would shoot at me, but no. She's just shooting at the rats, so remember, close the doors and loot them. Also, there is this little thingy in the dirt over there. And yeah, that's pretty expensive. I mean, that's a lot of money for this stage of the game. Get out of here, rat. I'm busy. Again, you close the door, and this is where you find more loot. A lot more loot. An actuator. And now you actually can dehydrated water, which is basically a joke to soda. So soda is nothing but sugar. And this whole game is a corporate joke. Don't pick up those because she will actually see you and that means things will go bad for you. See, she'll kill the sprats. And then you can loot them for the hide, which is basically a junk item, but you can sell it. Now that's the barber shop, you are not really interested in that location. This is just Halcyon.
Friend of mine died a couple weeks back. Still ain't past it.
Huh. Anyway, you can also come over here and steal everything because this is the place of your new companion, but she'll arrive later. See? You can pick up everything you see and that goes on over there as well. Delicious food. I'll just take all her food. But I just like her dialogue lines, so I won't take everything. So we're basically done here, so let's go to the cannery.
Hey, you hear about Wilson?
Yeah, nothing bad happened to Wilson. You can also try to find more locations, but this is basically the blunt of everything. So let's go over here. Remember, this is stealing. Oh, that's not stealing, that's only picking up stuff. It's basically a lost and found office. Okay, so another thing is over here, bypass shunt. At this point we have quite a lot of things. Okay, let's open this door and we can actually loot a lot more in here. But it's a little tricky because there is a wandering guard. Sometimes you'll be up there, sometimes you'll be down here. So as you can see, we have fog kit, geographic scanner and a lot of bytes or whatever you want to call them. To be honest, I don't really like to risk myself just for that thing. Yeah, okay, that's enough. Let's go to the vent. Easy now, get down. Here is the vending machine where you can buy the power armor, but before you buy that, you might want to loot another location. And it's of course this place. Loose lips, pink lips, that's Bard. I don't know how you get inside that, but this is only you, this is the locker room. And as you can imagine, you will have a lot of fun in here. Armor parts, impact hammer, another one. This one is locked. We'll just have to open it later. Adreno energy cell. And now, of course, a lot of food. Pocket watch is also a good junk item. And this vendor doesn't really have what you want, but you might want to see this one. In case you like sneaking, this is a very good mod for that. Sure and straight, this is another excellent one. You might want to put it on your LMG, but it costs 4,000. Yikes. Also, this is a pristine shotgun. I'll explain more what pristine means when I get armor. Now... you could also go down here and steal some more stuff. Including this magpick over there. And a lot of ammunition and a light hammer and so on. The impact hammer, whatever it's called. That's just the bathroom, nothing in there. So even if you start with almost nothing, you can still buy the power armor if you just loot all the locations when you get to town. Now let's see how... Okay. And again, this is only a part of what you can steal or what you can, you know, get in the town. There are still many other smaller things that you can get. But for now, let's just get the power armor because that's the really important thing. So go to the vendor. By the way, I can sell to the vendors because to the vending machines because I have my hack off. What did I say? I have my hack on. So this is the basic ability. You can sell to vending machines just in case you kill all the NPCs or something like that. So this guy actually has the elite troop armor made ballistic. So this is power armor. So what's the difference between these two, you may wonder? This is double price, but this is a pristine item. It has the diamond icon, meaning it will lose durability much slower. And you'll also get more money if you sell it in town. So if you see something with a diamond icon, either use it or sell it. So we'll get a pristine one, but if you don't have the money, you can just get a normal one, which is basically the same thing, only it breaks down faster, so you have to repair it on the field. Probably. So let's get this beautiful thing. And I also want to get the helmet. It will intimidate people a lot. But you might also want to think about, so this was 17 armor, this is 9 armor, but this one is 17 armor, advanced defensive alignment. So again, you just have to buy one set for yourself and then you can buy the other one for your companion when you get her. So let's buy this one, yeah, the best defense. Again, this is just because I have this thing. Most of the hammers are not really that good in my opinion, so I'll just sell them. Again, you can just sell some of the food, nothing really important here. Also some of the mods you can sell, and this is the junk items. So this is basically junk, so sell them all, then buy it. By the way, this helmet goes with the armor, but this one is better. So I guess it's up to you what you want to use. And yeah, let's buy this one. What? I need one more. Okay. Let's see what we can sell. So let's buy the advanced one. It's the best choice, or whatever she's singing, that crazy lady. Then the helmet. Yeah, now you rock. Now you look impressive, yeah. We sure got up on the ladder of power creeping, right? Also, here is another place you can steal stuff. Yeah, I know. That's so sneaky and so... It's almost like cheating, but without the cheating. So let's go to the workbench and then I'll show you how to use the mods, install the mods that is. So if you install it, that's gone forever, you can't really use it on anything else, so be careful. Let's see, the armor is right here. So you have 3 skills and 1 utility. So let's install this one first. So I'm not really sure how they do it, but it said I had 3 utility, but I think you can only install one. So let's see if you install this one. The current one will be destroyed. So it's up to you. You lose that, but you'll get the defensive. So the decisions are pretty much permanent. So let's install this utility mod on here, because it will help you find items faster. And that's about it. Also for the guns, it's kind of hard to use them. So if you have a pristine item like this assault rifle, then you can modify it with the Magnum. But again, it's not really useful for this part of the game because the armor will be helpful for a long, long time. But some of the weapons, you'll swap them out pretty fast. Yeah, so that looks good, right? We have power armor, we have a huge gun. We are ready to kill almost anything right now.
Wish we had some better rations.
Yeah, I wish that too. That's stealing. So again, this is the normal part of the game where I just play along. So yeah, that was it. This is how you get your first power armor. This is what the diamond means, the diamond icon. And many other things. If you have any questions, just ask in the comments, and I'll continue my normal playthrough.
Welcome to the Spacer's Choice Constabulary. We are Halcyon's leading brand in Frontier Justice. The office is writing a promotion. Purchase 3 criminal investigations. As a Spacer's Choice Constable, I am authorized to grant you legal authority toward apprehending wanted criminals. Know how to carry yourself in a fight? I've got bounties out for these 3 marauders. Cross them off and bring me their fingers. Just 1 per marauder, please.
What?
Dust off the old fingerprint roller.
1 per marauder, please.
As long as your questions fall within the acceptable margins of curiosity. His likeness decorates many a wanted poster. Do you have any relevant information about this individual? I am obliged to warn you against forming acquaintanceships, friendships, partnerships, or any felicitous relationship with a wanted criminal. I am also obliged to inform you of our referral program. For every criminal you refer to the authorities, the board will reward you. I am obliged to remind you that questioning the veracity of the board's orders is a punishable offense. Consider this your last warning. Unfortunately, the arrest of Mr. Wells falls outside my authority. I enforce the company policy of Spacer's Choice in the region of Emerald Vale. Wells is wanted by the board. If you have information related to the location of Phineas V. Wells, you are required to submit that information. Something to report?
Oh, no, I don't want to give him away, that's for sure.
Been eating nothing but saltina for a year.
Also, if you want to save on Supernova, you just have to go back to our ship, which is a stupid thing. So for me to save, I have to fast travel to the ship, and then I can't fast travel anywhere, so I have to walk back to town in a slow mode. So yeah, that's basically how the game works for in Supernova. So let's see our little side quest. I know where most of these people are, but I'll just do them in another video. For now, let's just go to the cantina and have some fun, right? Look at this beautiful thing. Come drink your misery away. And you'll also check some dialogue when you enter here.
You read the latest report?
Only the part that said we ain't making our quotas.
If only McDevitt's folk hadn't abandoned us, Cannery could use those extra heads.
Nothing we can do about that.
How are you drinking from that bottle?
We can have another 0G.
As you can see, everyone is drinking, no one is really eating, so yeah, depression has really gotten to these people. It's almost like modern times in here. So yeah, if you don't want to make someone your slave, just call them your employee and give them a quota. Of course, that quota will always increase, the pay will remain the same, and after they get burned out, you just fire them or they die and get someone new. Yeah, so that's basically the whole city explored for some minor things. Like in the basement, you can actually steal their power reactor. And I think that's how you do the quest if you don't want to interact with anyone or do any quests. Hey, it works for me, so why not? Hey, right now I just have to make enough money so I can buy the pretty lady another suit of that armor, which is 500. And then I'll just be ready to go. Anyway, see you next time. Bye.